Praise the Lord, guys. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, please subscribe. If you are a normal subscriber, welcome to my channel. It's been long. I've not met you the whole day since yesterday, and I'm glad I'm here now. So I want to answer a question. Perhaps you watched my last video and now you are thinking, you know, I need to start fasting as a Christian. And if I'm a Christian, I'm not fasting. I just need to start. And I know that the zeal of the Lord has overwhelmed you. And now you feel like you just need to start with 40 days or 14 days or 7 days, whatever days you feel you want to start, but you're still confused. You don't know how many days you need to fast in order to, you know, to please God, in order to, you know, to feel like, you know, you've done it well. So I want to tell you that plainly, or to disappoint you. You thought maybe I will tell you, you know, the best days to fast, the best number of days is 3 days. Sorry, to your disappointment, that depends solely on you. It also depends on the leadership of the Holy Spirit, the way the Holy Spirit leads you to fast, you know, because at times you just spend your day normally and you're going through your duties normally, and then there's a conviction of the Holy Spirit that you need to start fasting. So you need to depend on the leadership of the Holy Spirit, and it also depends with you yourself. It depends with your program. How do you work from Monday to Friday? Is your work so engaging? How do you feel physically? Are you a food addict? Because if you're a food addict, you can't just start with a whole day. Even a whole day for a food addict without food, they can feel like they will die. So you want to start off. So the advice I had given you on my last video is, the best way to start fasting, okay, is to start small. So start with 1 hour. I'm sure staying for 1 hour without food, intentionally, not that you are on hunger strike or there's no food. You start for 1 hour, you're not eating, but there's available food, okay? You go to 2 hours, go to 3 hours, until you can go for a day, until you can go for 2 days, until you can go for 21 days, until you can go for 3 days this week, 3 days next week. You can decide every week you'll be fasting for 3 days or for 2 days every week, or you'll just be fasting specific types of foods. You know, you need to start small before you can get to that point. But in this video, I want to give you examples of the number of days that some people fasted in the Bible. And we are going to read scriptures together in this video so that you find out for how many days did people fast in the Bible. We know that Jesus fasted for 40 days, but that is the only one we were told. There are days he will go on top of the mountain for a few days, meaning he might have fasted even some days for a whole day, some days for 3 days, because if you go on a mountain for 1 day, you know, that is fasting, because you intentionally went on a mountain to pray. You carried no food. So let's go and find out. Did anyone fast for 1 day in the Bible? So we are going to look at the book of Judges. So you're just going to be patient with me, because I will be opening the scriptures and reading for you in this video. So the first book we are going to read is Judges 20 verse 26. And Judges 20:26 says, then the Israelites, all the people, went up to Bethel, and there they sat weeping before the Lord. Full stop. They fasted that day until evening and presented burnt offerings and fellowship offerings to the Lord. So there are actually people who fasted for 1 day in the Bible. So you don't need to feel guilty about fasting for 1 day, yeah? Because even fasting for 1 day is just enough. There are people who fasted for 1 day in the Bible. So long as the intention is right and the sacrifice is right, God will accept it. You don't have to go for 3 days at once or 5 days at once. You start small. The next group of people are the ones who fasted for one night, okay? For a whole night, they didn't fast. And we are going to read the book of Daniel, chapter 6 verse 18, and it says, "Then the king returned to his palace and spent the night without eating, okay, and without any entertainment being brought to him." So it is also possible you say that, you know what, tonight I'm not going to eat anything intentionally. And it has to be a day that, you know, you had a rough day at work, you're hungry, you're tired, but you're like, you know what, maybe tomorrow I'm not going to work, so I will decide tonight I'm not eating, I'm just praying, and you fast for a night only, and that is also relevant. You can just fast for one night, and that is also enough. The intention is right. You've done whatever you're supposed to do, you have prayed, whatever prayer you're supposed to offer, you have offered. That is well and good. The next group of people are the ones who fasted for 3 days. And we are going to read the book of Esther chapter 4 verse 16, and it says, "Go gather together all the Jews who are in Susa and fast for me. Do not eat or drink for 3 days, night or day. I and my maids will fast as you do. When this is done, I will go to the king, even though it is against the law, and if I perish, I perish." Okay, so you see how the kind of motivation, energy people had when they were fasting, the kind of conviction. They're like, you know, after we have fasted for these 3 days, I will go to the king, and if I die, I die. So that is the kind of conviction you will have when you fast. And so we see this group of people actually fasted for 3 days. So if you get to a point where you can only manage to fast for 3 days, don't be guilty about yourself. There are people who actually fasted for 3 days in the Bible. The next group of people are the ones who fasted for 7 days. And we are going to read the book of 1 Samuel chapter 31 verses 13. And it says, "Then they took their bones and buried them under a tamarisk tree and Jabesh, and they fasted 7 days. So it is possible for you to fast for 7 days. And if you can go for 7 days only, do not feel bad that you cannot go for 14 days or you cannot go for more, because there are actually people who fasted for 7 days in the Bible, and it was actually just enough. So it is possible to fast for 7 days. So the next group of people are the ones who fasted for 14 days. And that is in Acts chapter 27 verses 33. And it says, "Just before dawn, Paul urged them all to eat." Okay? "For the last 14 days," he said, "you have been in constant suspense and you have gone without food. You haven't eaten anything." So you see, there are people who fasted for 14 days in the Bible. Meaning it is possible for you to go for 14 days. And if you can only go for 14 days and not 21, that is also okay with you. You don't need to go for more than that, because there are people who actually did that and it was accepted before the Lord. The next group of people fasted for 3 weeks, 21 days. And that is in Daniel chapter 10 verses 3. And it says, "I ate no choice food. No meat or wine touched my lips. I used no lotions." Okay? I used no lotions at all until the 3 weeks were over. That is Daniel. Daniel actually fasted for 21 days. And for 40 days, we can read in the book of Mark, we can read in the book of Luke, Jesus fasted for 40 days. And the last group of people are the ones who fasted unspecified length. You decide to fast some days you know you don't, or you decide that this week you'll go for 2 days, next week you'll go for 3 days, which is actually also possible. You don't need to, go for specified, like the exact number of days that you go for, 7 all the time, 6 all the time, 5 all the time, or 3 all the time. You can decide that this week you'll go for 3, next week you'll go for 2, the other week you'll go for 1, the other week you'll go for a night. It depends with your schedule. It depends with the strength that you have right now. How many days can you manage at this time? And it also depends with the leadership of the Holy Spirit. Do not compete with others. Do not do what others do. Do not wish you were them, because you have not gotten to that particular point where they are. If you read the book of Ezekiel chapter 47, you'll see the levels of the Holy Spirit. That is the same way with fasting. If there are people who are the level of the Holy Spirit is at their knee level, there are people who the level of the Holy Spirit is at their hip level, it is at the shoulder level. So the level of the Holy Spirit is different to all of us, meaning there is someone who can fast for a night, there's someone who can fast for a day, there's someone who can fast for 3 days, there's someone who can go for 7, 21, 40, there's someone who can fast some specific foods and not others. It all depends with what level of the Holy Spirit you are now, because it is the Holy Spirit that gives us the strength to continue, that gives us the capability to go for a specific number of days. So don't push yourself, don't compete with others, and don't do a number of days because someone else is doing. And for you who can go for more number of days than your friends, don't go boasting to them and making them feel bad. You ask someone, you mean you can't go for 3 days? Me, I can go for seven. No, it is the Holy Spirit that has enabled you to go for those number of days. It is not by your own making. It is by the power of the Holy Spirit. So don't be proud, because it is the Holy Spirit that has made it possible. Just thank God and keep it secret. The next video, we are going to talk about how to appear when you're fasting. Because the Bible says that Jesus told them, don't be like the Pharisees. So we are going to find out in the next video, how are the Pharisees fasting and how should we fast so that we don't appear like the Pharisees. So you don't want to miss that video. So don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to press the notification button so that when it is released, you are the first to watch it, so that you do the right thing. You fast and you experience the goodness of the Lord that those who are fasting are experiencing. Don't be left behind. God bless you so much. See you again next time. Bye.